People, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today we're again full-faced, ready. We're gonna play with a palette, and I'm gonna play again with my Mercury Retrograde palette. Because why? Because I want to play with it again and want to see what I can do more with it. Ooh, that's closed down again. And yeah, this is what it looks on the inside. So I'm gonna do something different today, see what we can do with it. Play with it, have fun with it. So if you want to see that, then please stay. And if you're staying, then please subscribe to my channel. Hit that notification bell, hit a like, give me a comment, tell me what you think of it. And yeah, we're just going to play with the palettes. This is just like normal videos, my voiceover ones. So we're going to play with my eyeshadow and we'll see what we can make of it and what for look we can do. And I hope you enjoy everything I do. But then again, otherwise you wouldn't be here. So at the moment I'm at 191 followers, so 8-9 more to 200. Would be amazing if I could make it there by the end of the year. So if you want to help me out, please follow me. And now we're gonna go play with this palette. And we're gonna go in with the color Vortex on my E42 from Sigma. And we're gonna put this from my outer corner until the inner corner of my eye and just pack it on. I had to pack it on, like you can see, didn't go on just like bam, but when you make it work, it works, and it didn't have any fallout almost, so that's a really good thing, at least in my book, on my face. And as long as you can flick it away, it's not that bad, but it's always nice to not flick it away, because I recently did a look with my ColourPop palette and it did have a lot of fallout and didn't get it off my face, so unfortunately, but every so now and then it happens. But this palette didn't do that. It's amazing. It's, well, you have to build it up, but I prefer building it up and having no fallout than have a lot of pigment and a lot of fallout on my face. Because then I have to correct it. Of course, if I would have done my eyes before my base, then I wouldn't have corrected. But yeah, we're gonna put this on my eye, play with makeup. Hope you play with me. If you, of course, decide to follow me, then please subscribe my channel, watch my videos, do it all. It would be amazing. I'm at this moment when I'm talking into this of 199 followers, which is really, really amazing, because yesterday I had 169. Yeah. And 196, I'm sorry. In the Netherlands, you turn around the numbers, it's first 6 and then 90, and in England and in English that's the other way around. So yeah, sometimes I mix them up, sorry for that if I ever do that or ever go wrong, that's why. I am Dutch, so yeah, that's why I have to sometimes don't know all the words, or sometimes I'm not pronouncing it right, but I do my best and I'm having fun with it, and I hope my English comes across okay. So yeah. Now we're going to go in with my second color, that's the color Karma on my E27, again from Sigma. Like you know, the Sigma brushes are quite new to me. This one is already stained because I use them a lot. They work really nicely. I didn't expect them to. I have Morphe brushes and Jessup brushes, and I have now made my Mitchell brushes and Sigma brushes. But to be honest, the Sigma brushes stay the best in shape, to be honest. Morphe brushes are okay, there's nothing wrong with them, but they're not as good quality as Sigma. But then again, Sigma is way more expensive, so I don't know if I'm gonna go around and order more types of brushes from one brand that expensive. But to be honest, these brushes I have do really good jobs, so I'm gonna keep using them. They're good. I like to have more brushes and more things, but well, everything costs money, so I'm now trying to be a little bit less spending. My Black Friday haul, everything came in, so that will be a video up soon as well. Took a while because I bought a Beauty Bay, which is from England, and at the moment the packages take very long to be delivered. And it's going to be even longer, I think, because I've corrected them in England. They are not allowed to send anything anymore with people. So we shall see what happens. But then again, I don't have any makeup packages coming. So all my orders are in. So no packages coming for me anymore. I'm just kidding, will be in the future. I'm going in with the color Momentum on my M562 from Morphe. Nice and small brush. This one stays really good in put from Morphe. Maybe it's because these are the white hairs and the other ones are different, the black ones, but I don't know for sure. But this one's really good. It stays in the exact same shape. It's nice and small, which I like. And yeah, this is really good. Putting the second color around the first color again. Blending it everything into my skin. Where, because, yeah, the purple shades weren't that many matte ones. But I think this works. This works really nice. Colors are really nice. This palette is really nice. I really enjoy it and hope to use it many, many more times. Cause I like playing with palettes more and I hope you enjoy it with me. But again, you're watching me, you probably are. So I'm going to cut my crease again. P. Louise base and my mirror brush from the P. Louise as well. Works quite nice. I've not sped up anything anymore because I like to see what I actually do. All I do on one eye you will see. If I go back in, if I do everything, you will see it. And yeah, when I'm cutting it, being careful, I'm gonna make it a little bit more rounded shape than I normally do, because that's where it ended up. Yeah, I don't plan anything when I do my looks. I just look at the palette and see what the palette tells me at that moment, and that I'll do. So yeah, that's what happened. Now I'm gonna go back in with Vortex on my E42. Just to blend the cut crease a little bit and to make sure colors are on. Going back in for cutting my crease a little bit. And now we're going to do the best part, put shimmers on. This is the color Nebula on my 237 Jessup brush. This nice small packing brush, cause it works really, really well. Packs it on really nicely. You know, I use this brush very, very often. I love it. And I hope you enjoyed this look in my little video. And yeah, this color was a really nice shimmery color. You can't see it as good as good shimmer. There's very a lot of shimmers on it, to be really honest. It's really nice. Now I'm gonna go in with the color Ultraviolet. And this is on my 237 Jessup brush again. A new one, a clean one. Did not switch it around or anything, just a clean one. I have two of them. And we're gonna pack this color on as well. This color again needed a little bit packing to get the right consistency I wanted, but yeah, as long as it's worked, I don't mind, and it stayed on very, very nicely, this eye look, so that's a good thing as well. So yeah, of course there's also a difference in quality for high end. This is an expensive palette. I got it on Black Friday sale, so I got it a little cheaper. I got it 50% off, I think. That's why I bought it, to be honest. I have not bought any Huda products on full price. I bought it all on sale. Because, yeah, it's expensive. Even though I really like Huda products, I love it. They're really nice. I've not tried any lashes yet, so it would be nice to do that. But I will see. I just pack this on, enjoy it, have fun. Because that's why we're here. That's why I'm doing this. Because I'm enjoying it. I'm having fun with doing my makeup a lot at the moment. Because, yeah, to be real, I'm sitting at home doing nothing. Except doing my makeup. Because we're all in lockdown here. So it's nice to have a hobby, things you like. I'm going back in with both of the shimmer shades to making the transition better. So first one was again Nebula and then Ultraviolet now. And now we're gonna go and blend everything out with the Vortex on the my E42 to mix and match the colors and make them nice and cohesive with each other. I like it. I love playing with makeup, so that's a good thing. So that at least I'm not sitting at home just watching Netflix or anything else. I'm doing something, which makes me feel nice and I'm enjoying it. So thank you for joining me as well. And this is the color Haze, and it's going to be on my 234 Jessup brush, and this is going to be all the way down under my eyes. I like to use this blue color, and this was the only blue color they had, so I was in matte, so I figured put it under my eye, and it really works well with the top eye, I think. Really like it. If you think this look is somewhere else, probably is. I get inspired by a lot of people, and it's possible that I've seen this eye look before and just copying it out of my head. I don't know, but it is a possibility. Because I watch a lot of videos, and this palette is old, so there would be possible. But it's what I like, it's what the palette was telling me. And now I'm gonna go in with the color Mercury, and this is on a Luxe pencil brush from Morphe. It's an unnamed one that came in an eye set I started off with from Morphe. This is the first brush I bought. And we're just gonna put this in the inner corner of my under eye and a little bit in, blend it a little bit in. Going back in with Haze on my 234 to blend out the shimmer that I put on my inner corner. Yeah, and then we're gonna go in with Supermoon, and this is gonna be on my GS13. And we're gonna put this color on my inner corner of my eye, complete inner corner, and on my brow bone. Because nice and shimmery, I like it. And yeah, that's it. We're gonna be putting this in my under eyes. Gorgeous Beauty Bay pencil in Minted. We're gonna put on some lashes and some lipstick.
So, that's my face all done. If you want to know my lipstick, I'm sorry, I have no clue. It is nameless, but I really like the color with the eye look, so this is what I went for. This is from a Style Tone box I had a couple of years already, but yeah. Like I said, it's faded, so I have no idea what brand or anything it is. I just love the color. It's just a normal lipstick, not a matte or anything, but yeah. I like the look. I think this palette is amazing, but then again, I do really like that palette, so I really want to get the Naughty palette, the newest one, but I'll get it when it's not expensive or I have money again, because at the moment I can't pay it, so I can't afford it, so I would love to have it, but unfortunately, we have to do it with the older palette, but yeah. Came out amazing, the glitter is amazing. I went for the purpley on top and the blue on the bottom line. Yeah, you've seen what I've created with this. I love it. I hope you love it as well. If you do love it, I'm not gonna talk too much. If you love it, then please subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, hit a like, give me a comment, it would be amazing. Like I said, I wanna reach 200 at the end of this year. Hope I can make it, but we'll see what happens. And I'll see you in the next one. Love you all. Bye.